Across the UK, some of our biggest retail chains are shutting up shop.
People don't realise how much hard work it is in this store.
Pound Stretcher, one of the UK's oldest discount chains, has hit hard times.
You can't drag people in off the street and say, buy somewhere.
Aziz Tayyub and his three sons have hired a new CEO, Chris Edwards, who made millions when he sold his own. Aziz is forging ahead with new ideas to entice bargain hunters. He's recently turned to cut-price, taster-likey products.
I'd reckon something more a bit handwritten or a bit more scripty.
Yeah. No, that don't work.
No, it's a bit difficult to read, isn't it?
This is going to be the company's second stab at manufacturing their own brand of biscuits. It's head by Ram's idea to offer customers their own version of Chalky Fingers at a fraction of the big brand price.
To compete with Cadbury Fingers, they sell it at a pound. We want to do a similar product to do 59p or 2 for a pound.
This is my baby, and I want it to be successful. I have spent a lot of time on this. I would reckon doing 50p, we can do something like 10,000 units per week.
To save money and deliver customers cut-price deals, Pound Stretcher sources many of its biscuits in Turkey. Ram and Aziz's youngest son, Suhail, have come to see if there's any more they can snap up.
Welcome, nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
How are you? How about you?
Good.
I'm fine, now.
Good, good.
Thank you very much. We just released
the chocolate flavored one,
yeah.
Can you open that?
Yes, you can open.
Yeah.
You can have a taste. We just added the chocolate flavor in it.
It's a sandwich cookie,
sandwich
160
cookies.
Grams.
I want this in 500 grams.
500 grams?
Yeah.
That's my hat reveals.
Your hat reveals.
So, I'll give you 20 containers orders now.
That would be really great.
Yeah, so let's do 20 more containers of that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then 5 containers of the new caramel one.
New caramel one, yeah.
With new bulk buys in the bag, Suhail and Ram embark on an exhaustive taste test.
Where do you put the cream then?
We will put cream after the dishwash.
And feel the Oreo taste.
That's good.
Fresh cookie.
I can eat all.
I lost count of how many there, man.
How many biscuits you got?
I lost count. I'm extremely happy, you know.
Yeah.
You exactly done what we needed.
Yeah, perfect. And I'm also happy that we are
very good product.
Yeah.
How was the taste?
Is
very good.
How was the taste?
Taste is brilliant.
Ram likes his new Chalky Fingers, but the true test will come when they hit the stores. Will they find favour with Pound Stretcher's discerning customers?
In 6 weeks' time, those milk fingers will be on our shelves. I'm sure it will be one of the great products.
Stores, and what drives him is the pursuit of amazing deals.
That the way he's always operated for the last 40 years is he buys stock and he sells it. Simple as that. You know, he buys it for as cheaply as he can and he sells it for as cheaply as he can to get the customers the deal. You know, that's what he's all about. It's a very buy in bulk, pile it high, sell it cheap kind of model.
By resolutely securing a high profit margin on these bargains, the company's been kept afloat.
Because of Dad's strategy of requiring a high margin, we've actually survived, you could say. He's quite shrewd. He's a very shrewd businessman.
To pursue his policy, Aziz turns to Ram, master of the bulk buy.
You can easily call Ram Warehouse. Whenever I enter the warehouse, they fear that, oh, there's something more coming in. That's why Ram is into the warehouse. That one was bought as a clearance. We bought 22 trucks. I think I paid 30p for that. Yeah, I paid around 5p for this can. and we can easily make a lot of money on this. Where our competitors sell them at a pound, we are doing at 39p. That's where we are the winners.
When manufacturers have leftover stock, often near its sell-by date, discount retailers bid for the goods.
I enjoy my negotiations. Sometimes they may say, look, Ram, can you take 3 trucks in a day? I say, yes, we do it. I can accommodate my other regular lines and bring these clearance as a priority.
For these purchases, bidders can't always decide quantity. It's usually all or nothing. Ram's recently chanced its arm on a huge volume of fruit-flavoured drink.
3 weeks back, we done a bidding for a big truck parcel, where in total it was 60 trucks. So we have now received the stock and we are sorting it to all the stores.
The profit margin on these buys can be enormous if they're sold before they go out of date.
I think this we bought something around 5p. On this product, I'm making more than 80%. 80.
The goods are normally shipped out to stores in large quantities.
They might have bought, like, I don't know, 100 containers of something, and they've got to get it out to the stores, so that takes priority. So then something's got to give, hasn't it? You know what I mean? They can't send everything in. So if they send in so much of these new lines, bulk lines or whatever, then sometimes the day-to-day basic things get missed, which isn't really right, because that's their bread and butter in you, you know? That's what they need day in, day out. That's what they need, the customer wants.
Sometimes I feel, yes, I'm putting some burden on the stores, but if you look at the bigger picture, you know, we are here to make money.